Fox special presentation. Mariah Carey's homecoming special next.
Let's go, Mariah! Let's go, Mariah!
It's kind of good for the school. You know, we have a popular, pretty girl, you know, Mariah Carey, who went to school here. You know, it's kind of good.
We just heard that she's coming home to give a concert.
Everybody's talking about this. Yeah. Is the talk.
Can't wait for her.
Yeah, there were whispers and rumors, and when I made the announcement that it was a reality, the place became a buzz with excitement.
Everybody's all excited. The whole town's talking about it. You know, you got the administrators there and the students and the faculty.
There's going to be a superstar inside of our school.
People asking me, can I do special favors to get him into the concert? And I said, absolutely not.
A lot of like our friends have brothers and sisters who are in her grade.
They said she was just like any other chick.
She's gonna grow up and be a star, so she didn't care if she got bad grades.
You know she got kicked out of chorus?
Well, actually, the chorus teacher told us that he threw out a chorus once because she never showed up.
This is the most amazing night of my whole life.
Whatever. They can't do it.
WCLUE!
Just play the record, please.
Guess who's back in the schoolhouse spot? With two big tickle bitches for your mouth. Heartbreakers must partake of this sensation. So, get the two hits in the middle.
Oh, guess who's driving the vibes up a low life?
Yippee-yah, yippee-yoo. Yeah.
And when I talk smack, y'all better skip that like to the go.
Oh, you love so cool.
Heartbreaker when we apart and face. I wanna be the labels, scribble down, I hate you.
cause, but she knows she loves Jay because she loves everything Jay say, Jay does at all.
In school is like, because I know what mine it was like.
I didn't get good grades,
but
I made it.
But you made it,
and
too.
I stayed in school,
right?
And I got that diploma because education
exactly.
is very important.
Stay in school.
Yeah, stay in school.
Heartbreaker has to be my ultimate favorite. It's happened before.
What do you mean, like the girl took away the guy?
Yeah, like it's like real life. It's like if someone, you're heartbroken, you're. Boyfriend is seeing another girl. It happens.
Do you like the ensemble? I thought it was festive. Do you guys mind if we come down and sing this next song in the audience? Is that okay? That's all right?
Put your hands together.
like your gym today. Gym has never looked hotter.
Welcome back, Mariah.
Thank you very
Welcome
much.
Back. Nice to see you here.
Now, when I went to this school, I was on the honor roll.
Which role? I was Mariah Carey's high school principal when she graduated from Harbor Fields.
No, I got into a little trouble in the gym.
I think there were personality clashes between a very willful young lady and some staff members who saw things a little bit differently. She was, especially in gym, I recall.
But I actually liked gym, you know, when I didn't have to really participate in sports. Oh, the nurse's office. That was another one of my favorite places to go. Probably like in ninth grade, I sat at this table. Probably sitting on the table and then getting reprimanded. Memories, the colors of my mind. Okay, here we are in the in-school suspension room. Now, I don't remember that we had magazines. Why am I not on the wall of scholars? It's very nice that they're even letting me back here. Let's just put it that way. Hi, Chuck.
How you doing, Mariah?
How you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
Chuck and I went to school together. He's back here now, working, helping me out. We gotta talk in the cafeteria, right? You gonna talk? I asked, this is Chuck, and he went to school with me. And I asked him to get a picture of prom, and because we were at the same table. But my dress was a little bit of a scandal, right?
It was.
Why was it a scandal?
Because the school pitched in, unknowingly.
Because
you
know, why?
We had a little party. Well, you had a little party.
I had a party, and we charged.
To help support, yeah,
to help support the making of my prom dress.
Support the Mariah dress. That's what it was.
We made like $1,000 from that mess. That was a good party.
That's what happens when you sell beer.
When I went to this school, this song was popular, and I remade it for my new album, Rainbow, and it is called Against All Odds.
How can I just let you walk away? Just let you leave without a trace? When I stand here taking every breath with you, you're the only one who really knew me at all. How can you just walk away from me? And all I can do is watch you leave. Cause we share the laughter and the pain, and even share the tears. You're the only one who really knew me at all. So take a look at me now. Cause there's just an empty space. There's nothing left here to remind me, just the memory of your face. And take a look at me now. There's just an empty space, and you coming back to me is against the odds, and that's what I've got to face. I wish I could just make you turn around. Turn around and see me cry. There's so much I need to say to you. So many reasons why. You're the only one who really knew me at all. Take a look at me now. There's just an empty space. There's nothing left here to remind. at me now.
Where would the school newspaper, if someone who was aspiring to be a professional singer, like in our school, what would you tell them to do to achieve their goal?
First and foremost, you really have to believe that you can do it, and then be prepared to work every single moment of the day, in fact. There's a lot of people who can come out and have like one hit record and then go away, you never hear about them again, or there's a lot of people who are maybe like a producer will find them and they'll become a fad of the moment. An important part of my career is that I write my own songs and produce my own records.
What was not your greatest accomplishment, but what have you worked the hardest for?
I've worked the hardest for my freedom and for my ability to be in control of my career. I'm going to do my first song that I ever put out, and it's called Vision of Love.
Thank you. she didn't listen to what anybody else said, you know, and she just said, I'm going to be famous no matter what you say about me. I thought that that was pretty strong of her, like, because a lot of people told her, you know, you're not going to be famous, never, and she just kept saying, yeah, I am.
Okay, here we are in the main office, where I would come with my little late pass, because I was always singing and doing stuff till really late, so I would get here probably, that's the bell schedule right there. I'd get here around fifth period, usually, which was typically my lunch period. That really wasn't my fault. I was singing.
This is a fairly academic high school, and 90%+ of the students go on to college and pursue, you know, real academic pursuits. And Mariah was every bit as committed, but she had a lot of courage in committing in a different direction.
Well, because it was a whole big issue with my friends, parents, and everybody, and they were, and I'm not an advocate of people not going to college,
sure.
Obviously, but from, because I had already been singing since I was so little,
absolutely.
And recording and doing all that stuff, I right. knew there was no doubt in my mind, but a lot of my friends' parents were like, this kid is crazy, A, and her mother must be crazy to be encouraging this because it's not the standard
right.
procedure.
It wasn't the standard route in the school, but
right.
Today it makes so much sense, and it made sense even then, your courage in following that route because it was hard to be different. And I said, well, Mariah, follow your dream, and I want to really encourage you. But if it doesn't work out, you know, you can always come back and kind of talk to me about it. And as I look back now, that was really the kind and the right thing to say, but I certainly don't think she's going to need to come back and talk to me about career planning.
Yo, New York in the house, in Brooklyn in the house, uptown in the house, Dallas, are you in the house, Boogie Down, are you in the house, Sacramento in the house, Atlanta, Georgia, are you in the house, West Coast, are you in the house, Japan, are you in the house, everybody, are you in the house, baby, baby, come on, baby, come on, baby, come on.
Anybody's parents, because I'm riding on people's skin. Come here, come on up. What's your name?
Rob.
Rob? Okay, come on this side. And
I need a marker to sign the cast. What happened to you? How did you break your thumb? In football? Okay. You want me to write? There's not that much room, Rob. Okay. To Rob, love.
Oh my God.
And be careful in the, on the field. Be careful on the field, Rob. Don't break anything else.
It's just a bizarre coincidence that I came back here and now you're part of this staff. Let's discuss this. Did I get gypped out of prom queen or not?
Personally? Yes. Because I voted for her. I'll admit it, she asked me to. She did.
Me and Nick invented that whole thing. There was no, we watched Pretty in Pink and 16 Candles, and we just were like, how come we don't have a prom king and queen? So Nick got on the student council, then I campaigned heavily for the votes, and then I almost wasn't allowed to go to prom because of a little problem I had in gym class, so I almost wasn't allowed to go.
Called lack of gym, right? A little girl who was here at your concert tonight.
You're good.
I know, thank you. Right? She came to me practically in tears because she wanted to give this to you.
Okay.
She asked me if I could. She doesn't know I know you,
okay.
But from her to you as one of your fans, almost in tears. Hopefully if she's watching, I gave it to her. Just
he
remember
it.
Me.
I wrote this next song during the time when, after the whole Columbine incident happened, and there was just a lot of stuff that was going on that was really negative, and I was thinking about my experience when I was in high school and junior high, and just thinking that you can really feel like when you're not a part of a certain group or your friends get mad at you or something's going on, you can really feel like it's the end of the world, right? When I wrote this song, I had my days in junior high and high school in mind, and I also had my own struggle that I'm still going through now, okay? It's about if you have peace within yourself, nobody can touch you no matter what happens.
They want to say, try to bring me down, but I will not allow anyone to succeed. Hanging clouds over me, and they can't try hard to make me feel that I don't matter at all, but I refuse to fall to him. I lose faith in my dreams, cause there's a light in me that shines brightly. They can try, but they can't take that away from me.
Say anything they want to.
so here we are on my old football field with my very good friends, 98 Degrees, and you guys have a really hot new Christmas album out. I really like
it a lot. Thank you.
This gift is very good. And also, you guys are going to stay and sing a song with me later, right?
Yes, absolutely. Yeah,
we'd love to. Sing. We're going to find Joe. I'm going to do Thank God I Found You, so stay tuned. Welcome back. The start of my fantasy. Oh, dear. I remember when I first walked in these doors, I was really scared. We have these rainbows here. And me being a person that's multiracial and, you know, hoping that one day the world will all kind of not have to judge each other because of what we look like, because of what color we are, because of what country we're from, hoping that we can kind of come together in that respect. And going into the new millennium, hopefully that's something we can all keep in mind. Thank you. Can we try and keep that in mind? It's also about getting through, like after a storm, sometimes you see a rainbow. And so I wrote this next, it's sort of an interlude, and we're gonna take you into another song that you might know. I'm gonna try and sign everything for you.
Love, oh, 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 when you face the world.
cause any food fights like I did in eighth grade. Be good.
She's on her way. She's making a move now.
She's on her way. Who knew that I'd be walking through my old junior high when I went here, and they'd be going, she's on her way. She's making her way down the hall. Actually, this is very Romy and Michelle. Okay, where are we going? This way.
No, all right.
We're going to the States?
This is the other one because I was watching. What I want you to do?
I don't know. I mean, I've been all over the world pretty much, and I've performed in so many different places, but it's hard to describe the feeling that I got when I went back to my junior high and I sang for the kids. And there were a lot of the same faculty members who were there when I went to the school. It just made me feel like I've come full circle. And I had so many issues within myself when I was growing up that I think this was a very important part of my healing process. And it's something I'll never forget.
Next at 10, a major announcement concerning the transit negotiations. We should get word whether there is a deal or whether both sides are still talking. We've got live reports from all over the city. The news is just moments away.
Oh, yeah. Ooh, love the sweatshirt.
Lots of All Navy.
Performance fleece.
It's always in good taste.
Mm-hmm.
The holidays make me feel so warm and fuzzy.
That's just a performance fleece.
Hurry in for our item of the week. Performance fleece hooded sweatshirts for the family.
Now, boys, we talked about this.
Freshy sprays, only from Parfum de Coeur.
Now there's a makeup that's beautiful and beneficial. Neutrogena Healthy Skin Makeup actually improves the look and condition of your skin every time you wear it. Clinically proven to firm, smooth, soften, with flawless coverage. Beautiful and beneficial. Neutrogena.
The angle shoe, sir! I'll make it burn.
Nice job. Now we're going to have to call his parents.
We'll use 1-800-COLLECT. Save him a buck or two.
Hi, Mom.
Use your head.
1-800-COLLECT.
Save a buck or two.
Or three.
Yeah.
came to me.
Looking back,
I guess
it shows that we were destined to shine
the rain, to appreciate
the gift of what we have.
Am I gonna win all over again to be able to feel
this way?
So thankful I found you.
Yeah.